war in Europe, record high energy prices, and a return in inflation are just a few of the factors contributing to market volatility today. Despite this, our multi-stakeholder approach and long-term outlook help us minimize the impact of these factors and these macro undercurrents. We as sustainability investors are seeking companies that exhibit corporate karma, because these are the companies that look to not only survive, but thrive in times of macro uncertainty. One area at the moment experiencing short-term pressure is the recent strength in energy companies, following the surge in oil and gas prices after the Russian invasion of Ukraine. And our conclusions from recent events is that the high and volatile fuel prices we have seen only serves to increase the urgency of countries and governments to reach their full climate transition and focus companies on reaching their net zero carbon commitments. Schroders is a signatory of both the Climate Action 100 and the Net Zero Asset Management Initiative, and was one of the earliest financial institutions to be a pledged member of the Science Based Target Initiative. And so we know what it takes to make a climate commitment and work towards a climate goal. We as investors, alongside our active ownership team, have made an ambitious engagement plan targeting over 500 companies across a wide range of sectors to encourage companies to commit to climate goals, make transition plans, and allow us to measure and monitor performance as they progress. Our audience from the last video update will know about one of our core holdings, Recruit, a Japanese recruitment company best known for the websites Glassdoor and Indeed. We successfully engaged with this company back in 2019 around governance, particularly around board level and executive management level gender diversity. Buoyed by that optimism, we re-engaged with the company around climate transition plans, and we were very pleased to hear the company announce net zero commitments in 2021. On a recent call with the company, we learned that they'd already made short and medium term ambitions in line with a 1.5 degree science-based target initiative. And importantly, these were linked to management compensation. The focus is now on how to incorporate and minimize indirect scope 3 emissions, which are mostly from the commuting of their temporary staff. Now, measuring and managing scope 3 emissions is not an easy task to do. And so they have initiatives around promoting remote working and promoting green transport, not just for their own staff, but for the staff that they're recruiting to their clients. We will continue our dialogue with the company, particularly around environmental disclosure, as well as new initiatives around transparency on scope 3 emissions. And we'll look to share best practice across our portfolio of companies that are faced with similar climate challenges.
Investment involves risk. Please read the relevant offering documents before investing.